Good day everyone. In today's tutorial, I want to show you how to do land use land cover change detection, simulation and prediction using a plugin called MOLUSCE plugin in QGIS. Permit me to pronounce this as MOLUSCE. So let's go to ArcGIS and show you something. In ArcGIS, I've already prepared land use land cover for year 2023 and year 2017. So we want to do the prediction and want to see the change detection between this land use land cover for 2023 and 2017 in QGIS using the plugin called MOLUSCE. So to do that, open our QGIS. Let's load in the land use land cover we have prepared for 2017 and the one for 2023. Click on open to load them in. Yes, we have it here, so we can change the symbology. Right click and come to properties. So under rendering, let's change it to single band pseudo color, and let's change this to quantize and click on apply. Click OK. So let's do same for 2017 land use land cover map. So come to properties. Instead of single band gray, let's choose single band pseudo color, and let's change the mode to quantize and click on OK. Yes, if you have other variable maps like slope or distance from roads, you can add it, but for now we are going for these two. Now to do land use land cover change detection, we need to install the plugin called MOLUSCE. To do that, come to plugin and click on manage and install plugin. So come to all and search for MOLUSCE. This is it. Because I have installed it already, that is why it's showing reinstall and uninstall. So if you have not installed the plugin, just install it. So after installation, we are ready to do our change detection. So let's click on close. So to do change detection, come to raster and come to MOLUSCE. Click on MOLUSCE. Yes, it will automatically load the layer you have here. So then you will see here initial. The initial will be our year 2017 land use land cover. Then click on initial. So it will automatically load it here and indicate the year here. Then the final, click here and click on final. It will also load it here. So if we have spatial variables like slope or digital elevation model or distance from road, so we are supposed to load it here just like this. Click here and click on add. So it will load it. So once you load it, the condition is that they must have the same geometries. So you load it here and click on check geometry. So the geometries of the rasters must be matched. Then click on OK. Then you have to evaluate the correlations. So when you click on these correlations and check for correlation between the variables you have input, click on check. So if you assume we have those variable map, it will calculate and show us the correlation between the variable spatial variables. So then now we want to see the change in land use land cover between year 2017 and 2023. So to do that, come to area changes. So when you come to area changes, click on update table. So it will compute the cross table and give us the cross statistics, that is change in line use between line use, and also transition matrix will also be generated. Yes, you can see. So this represents the changes between land use and land cover. So you can equally change the units here by clicking here and change it to square kilometer. So it automatically change, and you can click here. So you can control C to copy it and take it to Excel and paste if you need it there. So now we have to create changes map. This very changes you are seeing here as statistics, let's convert it to a map. So to do that, click on create change map. So in this case, let's label it as change map. Then click on save. So it will take some time to generate it. The time taking depends on the area extent of the map you are working on. Yes, the change map has been created. So we can minimize this and check that map to see. So we can expand it and see the change map. So this is the change map generated, and you can change the color to match the same color we are using. However, let's move further. So let's bring back our MOLUSCE. So we have created the change map between 2017 and 2023. So this is the change, and this is the percentage change, and we have used it to create a map, which is this change map. So now let's bring back our MOLUSCE. We want to do transition potential modeling. To do transition potential modeling, click on this define sample, and we are the mode you want to use is random. We want to use random, and here leave other things at default. So it will help us to generate a graph that is neural network learning curve. So after you have changed this one to random, click on train neural network. So it will start creating the neural network curve for this, and the overall accuracy is being calculated, and the minimum validation overall error is also being calculated. Then the kappa coefficient is also being calculated here. So it will take a while depending on the area coverage of the land use land cover map you are using for this analysis. So the training of the neural network is completed. We did that using artificial neural network. So where this one is what the software we use in prediction. But check here, we can see the current validation kappa. The kappa is about 96.9%, and I think about 85% is okay. So we have 96.9% here. So let's now go to cellular automata simulation. So uncheck this certain C functions and click here. So let's predict. Let's say prediction 2030. So we are predicting for year 2030. So click on save and click on start. So of course you can also choose increase the number of simulation iterations, but I left it at one. So it will take some time to do the prediction depending on the area extent of your map. So the prediction for 2030 is done. So as it being, we have a reference land use land cover for 2030. We could have done validation. So in that case, we'll have input the reference LUC and the prediction to see the level of accuracy of our prediction. But since we don't have it, we are stopping at this simulation. So this is how to do a change detection, simulation, and prediction in QGIS using MOLUSCE plugin. So we can now go to our ArcGIS and load in the change map and also the prediction. Click on add map. So this is our prediction 2030 and our change map. Click on add. So is it, let's check out this prediction, that is the 2030 prediction. Right click and come to properties. Then instead of strength, let's make it unique value, and is it, click on OK. So we can see the predicted for year 2030. This is 2030 and this was 2023. So you can change the color to be the same. So this is 2030 prediction and this is 2023. Thank you for watching.